I'm going to show you how you can turn one long video into multiple short form clips or just one clip, like all of these clips you're seeing on the screen right here. For this, I'm going to use a computer, but don't worry, you can also use a phone or a tablet or any sort of mobile device. Everything works with SendShort AI, which is this tool that I'm going to use in this tutorial. So join me as I take you through the step-by-steps to make a short clip. First, you're going to click try for free or log in if you have an account like I do. And that's going to take you to the dashboard right here. What you want to do is you want to click long videos to short. Here you have a representation of how this works. So just click this. And to turn a long video into a short, you can either import the long video if you have it downloaded on your phone or computer, or you can also copy and paste a YouTube video's link. Like I'm going to do with this video from Joe Rogan. I'm just going to copy the link. I'm going to also close it. And I'm going to paste it here in SendShort. And just for confirmation, you're going to see the thumbnail of this video. So this is confirmation that this is the video you're going to clip from. Now, if you want the absolute easiest route, you can just click auto-generate videos and you can set three videos and also other effects that you want to add to the video. And if you're not sure what all of these features do, you can just hover and it shows you here what each of them does. Let's do this manually. I'm just going to tick this off. I'm going to click import. And we're going to wait a couple of seconds for the AI to import the video. This means the AI is going to scan the video, is going to download it for you, and in just a matter of seconds, it's going to take you to the editor where you can select segments from the video and clip them into those viral short form edited clips. So let's just wait a few seconds for this. In a few seconds, it should take us to the editor, which is this. This is actually before the editor. This is where you can make the clips. This is where the magic happens. So if I'm just going to press play.
We're very fine people.
This is the video. This is the same as watching it on YouTube. However, if you're going to click anywhere here, you can clip them. You can take the clips out yourself, or my favorite part is to just click AI moments and wait a couple of seconds again. And the AI is going to listen to the video and is going to extract segments and clips that it thinks will go viral. So for example, if I click this, it takes me to the moment where it thinks a good clip will happen. So I'm going to select the moment. Let's just take this random clip, or matter of fact, let's just choose this one because it's shorter. So select moment, go to moment, select, and click clip one short. And it's going to be my first clip in SendShort. First, I'm going to click create. Wait a few seconds, and now you're going to see a message where the AI is telling you, hey, you could clip more videos, or you could just go back to the dashboard and wait while I'm done turning this long video into a vertical short form clip. So let's just wait for this, and then we're going to open the editor together and see how to edit this video before going live on TikTok Shorts on Reels. The video should be done any minute now, all right? You can close this tab if you don't want to make any more clips, so I'll just close it. And this brings us to the editor. I'm just going to reload the page and just give it a few seconds for the captions to load. So let me play the video for a few seconds so you can see what it looks like when it's freshly generated.
That's what they're putting out there.
Yeah, it's causing division.
And you have a
great. On the left, this is your video's transcript. So this is all of the words that are being said in the video. You can change them. You can leave them as they are. Most of the time, they're like 99.9% accurate to what's being said in a video. Now, if you want to go to the Models tab, you can change the captions to a different font. Maybe you want to use this one. You can also change the emojis and everything. For example, this font has an emoji next to some of the keywords. Let's just play for a second, for a few seconds, so you can see what it looks like.
Yeah.
Joy division.
Well, it just makes you realize this is the...
Great. This is your clip. Now, for example, another thing you can change is the keyframe. So if you don't want Joe Rogan on the scene and you want like... let's just say the background, you're going to do this. And now when you go to another menu, you're going to see this scene is in the middle. But the AI is always putting the speaker. So it knows who is speaking and it's always changing the frame to them. And they're in the middle of the screen. Like, for example, if you go to this clip right here, this next frame, you can see this guy.
Just of each side.
Yep, so like the shit.
As you've seen, I've clicked in the exact moment where it was changing to this guy speaking. Now, he's a bit off center. That's not a problem. You can leave it like this, or you can follow him with the cropping tool. Now, another thing you can do is you can insert a B-roll, you can add hooks, images, audios, text, or a custom thumbnail for your video. You can also auto-translate the clip in another language. You can change the playback speed. You can add transitions. For example, if we go down to the B-roll section, we can click auto B-roll and the AI is going to add effects and transitions where it thinks it's suitable. If you don't like them, you can also just add them manually here. Like just open the menu. These are all of our transitions. A lot of transitions you also find on CapCut and other platforms. You can add the B-rolls manually or let the AI do it. And when you're ready, you can also change the aspect ratio for your video and just click export. And then the AI is going to give you a download link for the video. And then you can schedule it to go live on all the short form platforms. Very soon, we're also going to integrate Instagram and Facebook. So you're going to be able to schedule videos to go live on Instagram and Facebook. Right now, it only works for YouTube Shorts and TikTok. So stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching, and I really hope you found this tutorial helpful.